She doesn't look like a knockout artist, but she puts girls to sleep. Jelena, how do I pronounce your last name right?
Mrdjenovich.
Mrdjenovich.
You got it.
Close enough. You're Canadian. You're a champion. You've been boxing. Your 50th fight already. You passed it?
50th fight, so this will be my 51st fight in June.
What's your record now?
Actually, to be honest with you, I don't know.
I know you have a lot of knockouts, though.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I win. I'm a 66% knockout ratio of my wins.
What was it like to be here tonight at the WBC event, Hoopla, raising money to charity to help fighters?
Listen, the WBC always puts on an amazing event. And so now what they partnered up with Hoopla, and they're doing this phenomenal thing for Retired Boxers Foundation in honor of Jose Suleiman. You can't ask for a classier event.
Now, you have a fight coming up. Tell everybody. June 22nd?
June 22nd, yes.
Who are you fighting? Do you know?
Vissa, I'm going to murder her name, but Vissa Travado.
Okay.
Out of Italy.
And where's the fight? Is it back home?
It's in Edmonton, yes.
Good. You're going to sell out?
Bye.
You know Julio's wife?
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Good seeing you. I'm going to come visit you guys in Tijuana very soon. Julio's in camp, no?
Yeah, he's going to stay there about an hour away.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll go visit him. Have a good night.
Okay.
Nonito looks like an action hero, some kind of movie, Transporter 5.
I feel like we need to do like a Marvel like, type thing. Like,
yeah, you told me Wonder Woman.
I got it.
Are you guys going to Hakkasan?
That right?
I got a text message. Nonito's in Hakkasan. I'm like, how can he be in Hakkasan?
Might be, but I have.
Okay,
so you're leaving?
There's no way. I'm not going to Hakkasan.
You're not going to Hakkasan?
No.
But he might go.
He might. You know, mom always has to go home early.
That's
mom
true.
Mom has Cinderella curfew.
Somebody has to take care of the baby.
Right? And it's they don't want a picture of me on there.
Nonito. Nonito Donaire. So, Jelena, where do people follow you if they're watching this video?
At Jelena Boxing.
Jelena Boxing?
Yeah.
Spell it out.
J-E-L-E-N-A Boxing.
And there are a lot of stars here tonight. Who are some of your favorites from the legends?
Oh, my goodness. Roberto Duran, my all-time favorite. Julio Cesar Chavez, Jeff Fennec. You have Lennox Lewis. You have the who's who of boxing in this room right here. So, I mean, if you weren't here, you'd want to be here. And maybe next.
By the way, have you ever met Clarissa Shield?
Clarissa's amazing.
Clarissa, have you ever met Jelena? She has over 51 pro fights. What can you tell me about her?
She fights at 126. I found it out today. I thought she was bigger.
Yeah. She's tall?
Yeah, she is tall.
Guess the shoes. Hold on.
But you know.
But then also too, she walks around probably at her weight. Like to be 126, I get pretty big to fight 160. She's about like a 130 right now.
So I'm a veteran in this sport. So I'm 36 currently. So I've.
Girl, look at how young she looks. Look at this.
So
look, you can't buy that.
We're a veteran coming to the new age of boxing, and she's gonna carry the sport.
Jelena, what is that about her success? Now. Two gold medals,
amazing.
Multiple belts.
Amazing.
Nobody thought she could win, and she destroys.
I don't know if nobody thought she could win.
Hello.
I think
you, because you know boxing. I'm just going off what I see online.
100%.
Am I wrong?
I mean, this is the difference. This is where now the women of past boxing and the ones who built the sport were able to make it so women could be in the amateurs in the Olympics.
Yeah.
And now this is the future now. So it's kind of all becoming full circle where now I have a hard time feeling myself as a pioneer in the sport, but I've been around for eons. And this is the future of women's boxing. I would love to be a part of the future, but let's be honest, I'm turning 37 soon, and this is where the sport is going. So to see someone as amazing as Clarissa take the torch and carry it on and do phenomenal things and represent the sport in a classy way is humbling.
Did you
so
know
it's amazing.
Her opponent last fight, you know what's in her mouthpiece?
I saw that.
You know, but you know what? It's a time to be classy, and it's a time to talk trash, and it's a time to be humble and embrace your opponent. And I think I did everything right for my last fight, even though a lot of the, you know, women before me, you know, say I talk too much and I better back it up and that's not classy. People have to realize, women, we have to sell our fights. Nobody wants to see me and him a fight if we're at the weigh-ins and we're kissing and hugging
that's
each other
true.
Saying I love you.
You're right.
You know, but I did have a lot of love for him, and like, you know, deep down inside it was like, I did love her competitiveness. I love that she was undefeated for 9 years. I love that she took the challenge against me knowing that I'm a badass bitch.
That's true.
And she was like, I'm a badass woman and I want to fight her.
That's so amazing.
I love that she stepped up and that we made that fight happen, because in women's boxing, there's only one other woman who's undisputed, and that's Cecilia Brockton. So to have it at the middleweight division was great.
But you know, I've known her for many, many years. It's hard for her to get fights. You know how many times she called me, I have a fight, a week later, fights off. I have a fight, fights off. I have a fight.
All these girls are fighting to keep their own. That's why you don't have the best fights getting done yet. Everybody wants to keep their own. Nobody wants to take that risk for the high reward. You know, it's like a low risk, low reward. But now it's like, you take a risk, you get some reward.
That's true.
Now. Girls just don't want to lose that own.
Well, I think the thing is every fighter has personalities, right? So yeah. You guys, I mean, what you do with...
Carlos, have you met two of the greatest female fighters? Clarissa Shields, a two-time gold medalist. She's a champion right now. And Jelena, she just fought on Showtime, making records, and she is fighting in a few weeks.
Yes. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You were talking about women in your speech.
Thank you.
They're pioneers in their field.
Yes, they are. We celebrate your brilliance, your greatness, and especially that you're doing it with class, grace, and dignity.
Thank you.
All right.
You gotta walk one of them out for their next fight.
Huh?
You gotta walk her out for her next fight.
Yes. You gotta come to it. You gotta come to her concert. You have to see my wife play drums.
When are you
from? When do we play? A couple of weeks.
Yeah.
A couple of weeks. Because you know, I'm saying this from my heart. When you hear our music, you start to cry and laugh, and you don't even know why. That's because there's a spirit in our music that is purely African music. That's all happening.
Okay,
so when you come celebrate with us, and we can change this world.
I believe that.
From fear to joy.
Fear to joy.
Carlos, un mensaje a nuestra gente.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Carlos,
one thing. Who's your favorite? Wait, who's your favorite of all time?
Sorry?
Your favorite fighter of all time?
Jack Johnson.
Thank you so much. Have a good night. Bye. See ya. Hey, that was pretty good, huh?
Yeah, of course. You know what? He speaks so bravely. Like, everything he's saying is like, it's kind of powerful. You know what I mean? Like, even when he was giving his speech, I was like, oh, he represented the women. Okay.
Have a good night. See you at the fight.
Good luck in your fight.
Yeah, thank you. You still don't look like a fighter. You want to keep it that way? And here's Showtime Sean Porter about to leave.
Well,
everybody's bouncing right now.
Well,
so,
yeah.
Message to your fans.
Thank you.
That is Jelena.
What's up?
Why do you come over and say hello?
You don't say hi. You don't write. You don't call. You don't.
That's my line. I always say that.
Great. I'll see you later.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Ask her.
Always, everybody.
Yeah.
We should just be the greatest.
What did you think of the face-off today?
Huh?
That was electric.
Oh, it was incredible. It was incredible. I'm going to enjoy my watch, my Google watch.
Good speech.
Hector, go downstairs?
No.
Did you see the face-off today between Canelo and Dan Jacobs?
I got saw snippets of it. Yeah, it was amazing.
What did you think when... Let me ask... Bernard Hopkins, the face-off today with Danny and Canelo was electric.
Amazing.
Yeah, it's a big one. Everybody's leaving.
We're in the amazing spot. We catch everybody as they're on the way out.
Oh, you know Bill Haney, the father of Devin Haney? Have you met Jelena?
Hi.
She has 51 pro fights, like 30-something knockouts. And she's fighting again very soon.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And she doesn't look like a fighter, Bill.
No, you look very pretty. But I don't want to underestimate anyone. So, congratulations.
Bill is doing a great job with his son.
Yeah, I've seen it. I know the name. I've watched some fights. Amazing.
He reminds me of Denzel Washington.
Oh, no.
No. You ever seen Training Day? That's Bill Haney, the boss.
He's cool.
I see you tomorrow, Norm. So, it's a good night of boxing, exciting. Message to your fans, stay tuned.
Oh, thanks for supporting, and stay tuned. Hopefully we'll have some the unification fights coming up, hopefully. Maybe one day.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceTheReport.com. I'll be back reporting. Hold on, let me see.